I wanted to switch topics to the more than 2,400 jobs that have been lost in the energy sector in Wyoming since January. They're good-paying jobs, benefits that provide for Wyoming families. You stated before the Environmental Council of the States on April 13th of this year that, quote, I can't find one single bit of evidence that we have destroyed an industry or significantly impacted jobs other than in a positive way. That's your quote. Well, I don't know what you're talking about. I hear it every day back in my state in Wyoming, heard it this weekend, how EPA regulations are destroying the coal industry. Your regulations are costing jobs. Are you going to tell the laid-off coal miners in Wyoming, in West Virginia, and Kentucky that you take no responsibility whatsoever for what is happening in coal country?
Sir, I think our responsibility is to make sure that when the energy system is shifting as it is in the market today, that we do everything we can to help those communities and those folks be able to cope with a shift in the economy and the energy system that we're seeing. And I'm happy to have any of those conversations if I can be helpful.
So based on your quote of April 15th, 13th, so you're saying you're not responsible for even one job loss in coal industry?
Sir, I did not say that is not what my quote said, but what I would indicate to you is I believe that the energy system has been shifting since the 80s, and it is time that we work with those communities and individuals to make sure that everybody in the United States has an opportunity to live well. And there are challenges in those communities without question, but the vast majority of that is related directly to the market shift, not to EPA regulation.
Mr. Chairman, I'll point out that 2,400 jobs have been lost in the energy sector in Wyoming since January, and I believe it's directly a result of the EPA actions. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator.